In the Yoga Sutras of Patanjali, Patanjali defines Yogasana as Sthiram Sukham Asanam. This is a state in which one is physically and mentally steady, calm, and comfortable. Naturally, in the beginning, we're not used to doing asanas. So with regular practice, our goal is to achieve comfort and ease with poses that we usually tend to avoid. In order to get the prana flowing throughout the entire body, let's see how yoga categorizes asanas into four different groups: standing, sitting, prone, and supine. And let us see some examples and the main benefits of each one. Indeed, without having done at least one asana from each category, the practice is not fully complete. And this way, it is easier to understand and remember asanas because they're simply put into boxes, as we may say. The best way to start our practice is up on our two feet, getting the energy pumping and activating the entire body. This series of asanas makes us feel light, stable, and comfortable. With regular practice, we strengthen the muscles of the core, the spine, and lengthen our muscles of the legs, the hips, and our upper back. And as our stamina improves, our muscles become well coordinated, leading to a stronger body and a balanced mind. I can conquer anything. Bringing ourselves to the ground, we enter seated asanas. Seated asanas lengthen the hamstrings and improve hip flexibility. Seated twists improve spinal strength and detoxify the abdominal organs. Becoming grounded and pulling the energies inwards makes it easier for us to observe the body, settle the breath, and calm the mind. And lets us move towards cultivating a better position for meditation and for sitting in longer hours of sadhana. Prone asanas are especially for our tired back. They have us turn over to lie on our stomach and relieve the weight that we carry physically and psychologically. They're useful for reversing our spinal structure, externally rotating our shoulders, removing any stiffness in our neck, and helping stretch our back. When we bend back and we open up our lungs and our heart, we enjoy deeper breaths and calm the mind. We end an invigorating practice with supine postures or lying on our back. These asanas bring a state of relaxation of the nervous system while also loosening the muscles. These asanas usually seem easy at first, yet to do them properly, it is hard because you have to release the tension of our muscles consciously. And if you do them properly, you'll get a deeper healing more than your sleep. And this is the fruit of a successful practice where we restore our body and calm the mind. In conclusion, there are four main types of asanas that are usually practiced: standing, sitting, prone, and supine. So try to incorporate at least one from each category and see if you feel how Patanjali defines yogasanas as Sthiram Sukham Asanam, or steady, calm, and comfortable. Enjoy your practice. Namaste.